Episode 5 of the R&B Divas, it's Dionne Warwick, Sophisticated Soul. The power, it rules the...
Walk on by. Why do you have to be a heartbreaker? What's it all about? Here we are, so close to the end now. Still holding on, we try and pretend now. Clinging to love, we both know it's dying. It's dying.
Welcome to Something Came From Baltimore. My name is Tom Gouker, and I will be your host. Remember that Something Came From Baltimore is a jazz, blues, and R&B podcast and radio show, and it's not really about Baltimore. And tonight, it's about the fabulous Miss Dionne Warwick, the sophisticated soul. We're almost finished our R&B Diva series, and we just have one more show to close out the series. The R&B Divas are Patti LaBelle, Diana Ross, Aretha Franklin, Gladys Knight, Dionne Warwick, and Tina Turner. You're going to hear my voice and high praise from the following music industry titans: genre buster Darnell Miller, the rapping professor Eartha Holly, jazz pianist Lafayette Gilchrist, band leader and educator Eddie Morgan, the former A&R gospel manager Jim Henry, the man with a voice, it's Marcellus the bassman Shepard, Kelly Bell from the Kelly Bell Band, music critic and author Christian Gerard, band leader Albin Jones, and the Funkmeister Duke Benjamin. Okay, Dionne Warwick has a sophisticated elegance that has caught the eyes of Burt Bacharach and Hal Davis. Hits. A switch to Arista, and now Dionne Warwick is back on the charts again. The Psychic Network, Solid Gold, and Instagram messages has proven that Dionne Warwick has a sense of humor, if anything. And that makes her a national treasure. Now let's get into the show.
If you see me walking down the street and I start to cry each time we meet, walk on by. Walk on by. Make believe that you don't see the tears. Just let me grieve in private. Cause each time I see you, I break down and cry. Walk on by.
Dionne Warwick, I guess. If I had to think of a tune that really kind of gave me a peek into who she is, I would say Walk On By. Because if you had a female crooner and you merged them with this strong sophistication, you would have Dionne Warwick. And not just the way that she sings, but the way that she presents herself. Definitely one of the people I'd like to have dinner with just to pick her brain and talk about everything she's seen and everything she's done. Walk On By, definitely.
And I think when Isaac Hayes did the Walk On By thing and he really electrified it and put that nice slow groove to it, I'm going to let, you know, Isaac keep a hold of that.
Walk On By. It's rare that I like piano, bougie boy type of music, but That's it. Even though Isaac Hayes did a great job on it, that song still hers. It's too signature. It's too signature.
Man, I like a duet she did with Felipe Wynn and the Spinners. called Then Came You.
Do you know the way to San Jose?
Find in San Jose. LA is a great big freeway. Put $100 down and buy a car. In a week, maybe two, they'll make you a star. Weeks turn into years, how quick they pass. And all the stars that never were.
And I'm gonna go to another one of those dark horse songs of hers that I love. And it's that quirky. Do you know the way to San Jose? Just quirky. You couldn't see Diana Ross doing that. You can't see Aretha doing that. Those are songs by Miss Dionne Warwick.
And I used to love I Know I'll Never Love This Way Again. You know, I didn't realize even in the old, like in the earlier part of her career, she had such range vocally.
I Know I'll Never Love This Way Again. That's another very emotional song. That's some good chemistry and good sex. Mm-hmm. You know you'll never get nothing that good again.
Remember just how good it's been. And I know I'll never love this way again.
A paid commercial presentation of Information Incorporated. Today, you'll find out what Dionne Warwick has to say about the Psychic Friends Network.
I think that anyone watching this show can benefit from speaking to a psychic.
Meet Psychic to the Stars, Linda Georgian. Hear what one of our psychics had to say about daytime TV's hottest couple.
Is this going to be the end of our relationship? I mean, is this going to ultimately destroy our... I asked her.
You asked her that?
Yeah.
Meet other soap opera stars who've called the Psychic Friends Network.
She was always elegant, very elegant, put together in style. Even her voice, I think that's what sold the songs, was that it was so elegant and pure and clean that she crossed over very well because of that.
You know, when you thought of one, you thought of the other because they were just a team. Again, he gave her the quality, she gave him the voice, and the two of them just put together something. Like you just said, with the greatest hits, that many tunes can come out with all quality.
And it's hard to separate Dionne Warwick from Burt Bacharach and Hal David. I mean, they kind of came up together. The music and her singing it for them came up together, especially back in the 60s. And, you know, in the 60s and 70s, early 70s, she was all over the radio with, like, Walk On By, Way to San Jose, Say a Little Prayer, Don't Make Me Over. And those are really big hits for her. Out of that group, what I like best, I just like the song, is Anyone Who Had a Heart. It's got a nice 6/8 groove to it. And I heard other people do it too, but she, it was written for her and she was the first to do it. So that was one of my favorites, Anyone Who Had a Heart.
Anyone Who Had a Heart. Mm. So I was always in love with Luther Vandross's version of that, right? And then this was years, years, years ago. I went back to listen to hers and I said, wow, it gave me a whole nother appreciation of what Luther did. But then it also gave me an even greater appreciation from where that song started out with Dionne on Anyone Who Had a Heart, you know, would know that I love you. I mean, it's just, it's one of those songs that truly makes you think about the one that you love, right? Or have loved, but also just makes you appreciate being in love and the fact that love exists between you and someone else. So yeah, If Anyone Had a Heart, man, it's one of my favorites from the great Dionne Warwick. She truly is a living legend.
Anyone who ever loved could look at me and know that I love you. Anyone who ever dreamed could look at me and know I dream of you. Knowing I love you so. Anyone who had a heart would take me in his arms and love me too. You couldn't really have a heart that hurt me like you hurt me, and be so untrue. What am I to do? Every time you go away, I always say, well, this time it's goodbye. I did. Loving you the way I do, I take you back. Without you I die, dear. Knowing I love you so.
I think that's a good distinction. You know, Dionne is not going to get on the floor and roll over like Patti LaBelle. She's not going to do the huckabuck like Tina Turner either. So, she's more refined, more elegant, more supper club, more uptown.
Oh, I have a story about her. So I worked at QVC, and I worked at broadcasting, and we're not allowed to be like you're excited about the artist.
Yes.
And I wasn't planning on being excited about Dionne, but there was only one person there's two people that I whacked out in front of, which was George Foreman. I couldn't help myself with his grills, right? And then Dionne Warwick was doing a Christmas album and she was coming on to do the Christmas album. She was in the green room and I walked in and I don't know why I did it, but I looked her up and down and I expected her to be like an old lady. She had like a gym body, put together, tidy waist.
Nice cut.
And I said, we're not really allowed to gush about people, but you're hot. Like, you're really, like, you look, I said, you look great. I wasn't expecting it. You know, like, I was going to go in there because I wanted to be a fan and just kind of glance, but she took my breath away and I was like, wow, I'm going to tell her she's hot.
She was blessed with this unique voice. And even though she was not the R&B girl when she broke out, they saw something in her that said, we can hitch our star to her and we can make hits. And she came on the scene and she delivered. A lot of the work that she did early, they went overseas and broke those songs. And her overseas audience just ate it up and loved her. And so that's kind of how I framed Dionne. But I will say what I love about her is my mother again. She's the one who introduced me to Dionne Warwick, because when I heard her songs, there was something about the songs that you got to feel at that time. You know, I'm 6, 7 years old, you know, starting to really, you know, music always had been my little radar thing that I loved. So I was an eclectic kid that loved everything. And there was one song in particular out of her catalog that just floored me. and that song is Alfie. I had never heard a record like that. That the lyrics, the whimsical way she sings it, and just like, and who is this Alfie you talking about? You know, I just love that record. That record really, to this day, that record still does something to me because I just love the content of that song.
You know, I gotta say Alfie, man. You know, nobody, I mean, you know, she just, you know, that's like, that's up there with Sarah Vaughan sending the clowns, man. You know, she's, Alfie is really beautiful.
What's it all about, Alfie? Is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when you sort it out, Alfie? Are we meant to take more than we give? Or are we meant to be kind? And if only fools are kind.
Say a little prayer.
Mine is probably more standard. I would say a little prayer.
I like say a little prayer. I know some people would say like, man, that's too pop, man, whatever. But I'm kind of a sucker for that kind of a thing.
Right on the heels of that is I say a little prayer. It kind of took Alfie and it kind of sped it up a little bit and put a little bit of groove to it, you know? So I love the vocal work she does in that because she had that wispy over the top vocal. They never buried her in the mix. They kept her voice on top of the mix, so she always rode along the top of the music, and she just made those things work.
That's another artist. She can still belt out stuff live, and she still performs too. And she's like in her 80s, and she's been singing. She's been singing since she was 6 years old. And still put on good shows right now in her 80s.
It's been so long since I last saw you. We're always running. No time for loving. Let's take some time out to know each other again. You know I'll miss you. You're my best friend.
I don't want to lose you. You're the one I'm living for. And I need you here beside me. Can't be without you anymore.
Let's make reservations for two. This is just between me and you. There will be no standing in line. 'Cause baby, tonight you're mine.
I'm gonna go with reservations for two as well, because I also am a big Kashif person.
It's an association. You mentioned Kashif. How many people today can remember Kashif? He was good enough that she picked up something that he did and made it even better. So it was the quality of everybody involved in the musical production that made it so great in those days. And I just have to stand firm on that.
But Reservation for Two with Kashif.
That's a throwback now. I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, the 1987. Reservation for Two.
I forgot about that song.
It's a great, great song. There's two as a duet, just kill.
Dionne Warwick, right when I was becoming obsessed with American Top 40, which was around 1982, 1983, I listened to it every single week and drive my parents crazy. Heartbreaker was one of those songs that was constantly on the radio, and I've always just sort of associated with that time period, and I've always really liked it. I think she's got a very distinct voice. I really like the way she sings. I've always sort of liked her personality also. Heartbreaker to me is the one that stands out in my memory for Dionne.
There will be another song for me, and I will sing it. There will be another dream for me, someone will bring it.
When Donna Summer did that MacArthur Park song, there was that segue that says, there'll be another time for me, and then he'll lose it. There'll be another song for me. Like, it seemed to me that the way that they were segmenting these songs, that was a different song. And it's not. That's a part of MacArthur Park. Dionne did a slow version of that segment. I mean, it was released as a single, but it was never really on an album. It was in 1968 to 1970. Unreleased tracks called From Within. It was a double album. So they released it, and it's a really slow, methodical version of her meditating just over that segment.
Dionne is the dark horse in this whole collection. And I say that because if you look at these other women that she's up against, and just in her career in general, she is really an unlikely original Black pop star. She's not really an R&B kind of singer. These other women, you put them in there, they can slide into the R&B bucket and stay there. Dionne's music was really pop music, and there was one major factor for that, and that was Burt Bacharach and Hal Davis wrote those seminal hits that you love of her. And guess what? Those are pop songs. There's no other way to slice it. Those are pop songs. You would have to take those songs and blacken them up to make them R&B songs today, because they're just not Black enough to be R&B songs.
Yeah.
Lyrically, they're great. Musically, they're great, but they're light. They don't have that bottom. They don't have that thing that makes your head snap, you know? That's the difference with Dionne against this pool of talent.
It's very hard, you know, when you look at the stuff she did with Bert and the stuff she did with Hal David, you know, it's classic after classic after classic. And crazy enough, recently, I have found myself looking at YouTube videos of Dionne Warwick from the 50s and 60s and just falling in love with her sound all over again. I started doing that a couple of weeks ago, you know, even before thinking about what we're doing here today. But she has so many classics, man. Alfie, Don't Make Me Over, Walk On By. One of my favorites of hers, This Girl's in Love with You, which of course Herb Alpert had This Guy's in Love with You. But you know, if you get an opportunity, check out her video on that, Deja Vu, which you already mentioned.
So when I was a little kid, I would raid my mom's friends, you know, records, and Dionne Warwick was always in that collection along with Herb Alpert. Like they were staples of white people's houses, where they felt, oh, we're being intellectual, you know, like we're buying an intellectual thing. Herb Alpert is like is considered jazz, and Dionne Warwick is considered like a jazz artist too for these people. It's like it's their intellectual 60s kind of vibe.
And my favorite song from her is Deja Vu, produced by Barry Manilow, written by Isaac Hayes. I mean, man, that's a unique combination. And favorite album is, of course, the Dionne album.
Well, for me, Deja Vu, the title cut, I love it. See, to me, Dionne Warwick, man, she have like a I like that's what friends are for. Yeah, I know people think it's sappy and sin, but see, I like, you know, see, again, she's, to me, her and Diana Ross, they don't have to have, although Dionne Warwick has a great, strong singing voice, but they don't have to overpower me. You know, they have a presence with her voice where she sings and you see. You know, there's something to be said for, you know, clarity, enunciation. You know, I can understand what she's saying. I know I sound old-fashioned or something. No, they have a clarity that breaks through, man. I'm talking about Dionne Warwick. It's not just a vocal clarity. They can break through with the vocal clarity and the emotional content.
I mean, her. So, I mean, if you think about her phrasing, she used to sing background for Dinah Washington. She sang background for Dinah Washington, for Benny King, for Solomon Burke, you know. So she has all of these different styles, plus, of course, the backbone of her being in the church, because she started in a church group as well. So all of that comes through her music, and she's definitely a diva. I mean, she's one of the most charting vocalists of all time. I think she had like almost 60 singles that hit the top 10. So, I mean, no one out there these days can claim that. But this is a woman who has definitely done it all, but truly a worthy of the title R&B Diva.
I hope you enjoyed the R&B Diva episode number 5 with Miss Dionne Warwick, Sophisticated Soul. This series is a special voice and song collage, and while you're hearing my voice, I had a lot of help from a lot of musicians, entertainers, DJs, and music industry leaders, and I thank you. This is where I'd ask you to subscribe to Something Came From Baltimore. We have one more diva left, and at this point, you just can't miss it. Episode 5, Dionne Warwick, Sophisticated Soul of the R&B Divas is complete. Next up is Episode 6, and the final episode. It's Miss Tina Turner. Gerald Albright, Rhea Schneider, Charlie Hunter, Duke Robillard, Sean Jones, Walter Beasley, Steve Swallow. Something Came From Baltimore is a jazz, blues, and R&B podcast and radio show, and it's not really about Baltimore. Subscribe to the podcast and listen to your favorite artist or future favorite artist that Something Came From Baltimore and be a part of that Be More Music scene. Joe Lovano, Jeff Kaufman, Paula Cole, Danuzo Makatani, Ann Passio, Chess Smith, Thumbscrew, mostly.